everyone. I, Aarti Bajaj, faculty in MCA department from Technion Institute of Advanced Studies. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on relational data model. In the relational data model, to display a relational database schema and its constraints, we must follow some set of rules. In the relational data model, each relation schema can be displayed as a row of attribute names. The name of the relation is written above the attribute name. The primary key attribute will be underlined. A foreign key, that is the referential integrity constraint, is displayed as a directed arc from the foreign key attribute of the reference table. Here is an example of the company relational schema diagram. Popular database states that each relation will have many tuples in its current relation state. The relational database state is a union of all the individual relational states. Whenever the database is changed, a new state arises. And in the database, basic operation for changing the database are insert. In this, to insert a new tuple in a relation. Second is delete. To delete an existing tuple from a relation. The modify. Modify as it defines to modify an attribute of the existing tuple. Here we show the example of the company database. Next is update operation on the relation. We can apply various operations on a particular relation as we discussed earlier. The first is insert a tuple. It is used to insert a new record in the particular relation. Next is delete a tuple. This operation is used to delete a particular record. Modify a tuple to alter or add the tuple or the particular attribute in a relation. The integrity constraint should not be violated by the update operation. The several update operations may have to be grouped together. The update may propagate to cause other updates automatically. This may be necessary to maintain integrity constraints. In case of integrity violation, several actions can be taken, like cancel the operation that causes the violation from restrict or the reject operation. Next is perform the operation but inform the user for the violation. Trigger addition update so the violation is corrected using the cascade option and the set null option. Execute a user specified error correction routine. So, an insert operation may be violated with any of the following constraint, like the first is domain constraint. If one of the attribute value provided for the new tuple is not of the specified attribute domain. Next is key constraint. If the value of a key attribute in the new tuple already exists in another tuple in the relation. Next is referential integrity. If a foreign key value in the new tuple reference a primary key value that does not exist in the referenced relation. Next is entity integrity. If the primary key value is null in the new tuple. These are the facts in which the insert operation can be violated. So, next discuss the delete operation may be violated only in the referential integrity. Like if the primary key value of the tuple being deleted in the reference from another tuple in the database, it can be remedied by several actions like the restrict, cascade and the set null. Let's discuss one by one. The restrict operation, it is used to reject the deletion. The cascade option, it propagates the new primary key value into the foreign key of the referencing tuple. Set null option, set the foreign key of the referencing tuple to the null. So, one of the above option must be specified during the database design for each foreign key constraints. So these are the rules which we have to consider for insert and delete operations so that they cannot be violated. That's all about the basic concepts of relational data model. If you want to view more videos, please subscribe Technia TV. Thank you.